All roads led to Nakaseke District for the celebration of President Yoweri Museveni's 80th birthday. The event took place at Chikajuko Village in Semucho Trading Center in Nakaseke District. The celebration has attracted many attendees as the country also remembered Museveni's long-standing leadership and the historical significance of Chikajuko Village in the National Resistance Movement's rise to power.
As Mzee turns 80 today, we pray that you will reward him for his faithful stewardship of the gifts and talents you gave him, for he has multiplied those gifts 100-fold. May you reward him with many more years of health, peace, and joy. We pray that you bless the new decade he's beginning, and let it be a wonderful new season in his life where he's able to enjoy the fruits of his labors. We pray that you will give him the blessing of seeing the dream of East African unity realized. It is the goal that he has worked towards his whole life, and we pray that you will let him see the fulfillment of it.
In the book of Psalms, 80 years of age is referred to as a special milestone in life. Accordingly, we can say that Your Excellency, you are counted among those who are lucky to celebrate 80 years.
The President thanked God for the gift of life and thanked his parents, as well as his wife, the First Lady, and the Minister for Education and Sports.
The celebration here is not about Museveni.
Norecho kujaguza kuno, sikuwa President Museveni.
Because Museveni did not do all these things alone.
Kubanga ebintu bino byonna ebituukiddwako President Museveni tabikoze yekka.
That's why I said when my children wanted to celebrate, they wanted us to go to Birembo. They had heard about Birembo. But I said Birembo is a bit far. Let's do it in Chikajuko. It's nearer.
In a statement posted by the Russian Embassy in Uganda X account, Vladimir Putin, the President of the Russian Federation, wished Museveni good health, well-being and success. He noted that since Museveni has been in power, the two nations have scored success in socio-economic spheres. The Ugandan Embassy in Beijing and the Ugandan Consulate General in Guangzhou successfully showcased Ugandan tourism potential at the China International Tourism Industry Expo 2024 in Guangzhou, China. The expo that took place between September 13th to 15th of September highlighted Uganda's rich cultural heritage, diverse wildlife, and the stunning natural landscapes to attract Chinese tourists and investors. The China International Tourism Industry Expo has been held for 15 years, since 2009. The 16th edition was described as a landmark event in the global tourism calendar. This year's CIT featured an array of exhibitors from nearly 50 countries and 30 Chinese provinces, attracting worldwide high-quality tourism destinations, service providers, and suppliers. President Yoweri Museveni has emphasized that peace and security are crucial for any business to thrive. The president made the remarks during the 5th biannual private sector CEO retreat held in Serena Hotel, Kampala.
The second strategic issue is the one we are still dealing with. This is the issue of the full monetization of the economy. The economy of Uganda, and I think the economies of other African countries, have never been fully monetized since the colonial times.
The president also highlighted strategies being used by the government to further steer the economic development of the country, such as the full monetization of the economy.
7 years after independence, only 4% of the people were in the money economy. Then Amin came in, and the figure, that small modern economy collapsed. Because they were calling that economy of colonialism and independence the economy of the three C's. The three C's meaning cotton, coffee, and copper, and the three T's, tobacco, tourism, and tea.
The Minister of State for Northern Uganda, Dr. Kenneth Omona, encouraged leaders to mobilize the wananchi on mass production and wealth creation.
The most important thing, Your Excellency, that now awaits, that now remains, is tasking all of us here, leaders in our various capacities, in government, the religious leaders, the cultural institutions, to avail ourselves and mobilize the population and the country for production.
The two-day retreat attracted hundreds, including the Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, ministers, members of parliament, among others.